In this work, we present our paper, Learning Object-Compositional Neural Radiance Field for Editable Scene Rendering. Virtual tour in a real-world scene is one of the most desired experiences for VR and AR. The emerging techniques, Neural Radiance Field, or NRF, learns directly from posed images and achieves promising results in novel view synthesis. However, NRF encodes the entire scene as a whole, which limits the ability to the editing tasks such as moving or adding furnitures. Recently, object-centric NRF enables editable scene rendering by learning one model per object and then perform joint rendering. But the training images captured for each individual object is infeasible for clustered real-world scene. While some early works realize object manipulation in an existing photograph, they require laborious modeling, fitting and reconstruction with human interactions. A common follow-up question to ask is, can we learn NRF for each individual object directly from the RGB sequence captured from cluttered scene and support rendering of the scene with new arrangement? The answer is yes. Here is our solution. Given captured images, instead of encoding the scene as a whole, we learn an object-compositional neural radiance field and support realistic rendering with editing capability for real-world scenes. To fill this goal, we first design a two-pathway architecture, the scene branch and the object branch. The scene branch encodes and renders the entire scene as traditional NRF does. And it can also render the scene background by pruning ray samples in user-defined region. The object branch renders each standalone object conditioned on the object activation code. Here we condition the object branch with code 1, and it renders the rectangular sofa with everything else removed. We can condition with code 2, and it renders another blue sofa. To render with user-defined manipulation, we can simply transform the shooting rays to the desired location. Here is an example, where the sofa has been moved back and forth. Here is another example, where the sofa is rotating in place. To obtain a complete view with object manipulation, we jointly render the transformed objects from the conditioned object branch and the surrounding background from the scene branch. Next, I will go into a bit details of our framework. The scene branch takes input as a combination of structure of NSVF and NRF to keep more details of the scene, and we follow the traditional NRF for rendering and supervise with photometric loss. For the object branch, in order to control which object the network renders, we additionally take the object activation code as a condition, and jointly optimize it during the training process. We add object-level supervision to the rendered color and opacity, and also take some special actions to handle object occlusion when training on clustered and real-world scene. Now, I will describe more details of object-level supervision. The resulting rendering of the object branch includes object color and opacity, where the object opacity is a sum of the product of transmittance and alpha of points along the ray. Compared to the scene-level supervision, the object-level supervision additionally requires a rough segmentation mask. This mask restricts the color supervision inside the visible areas and also provide guidance to the object opacity. The final loss for the object branch is a combination of a color term and an opacity term, which encourage the rendered object close to the observation, and the rendered opacity only opaque at the object area while transparent elsewhere. We find that our object-level supervision is fairly robust to segmentation noises. In the left example, the input segmentation is rough with jittery edges, and our scene branch can produce a smooth and accurate segmentation by rendering opacity. In the right example, we train our network to learn a vase deck with manually annotated rough segmentation. As you can see, our method even works for complex shapes. In real-world scene scans, target objects are often occluded by other foregrounds, which yields incomplete instance masks. If we directly train the network with these masks, it may overkill part of the object due to the visually ambiguity in the occluded region. To tackle this problem, we first use the scene branch to guide the biased sampling of the object branch, so as to reduce the point sampling at the occluded region. Then, we construct a 3D guard mask based on the rendered scene depth. This mask identifies the occluded region for the object branch and blocks the gradient flow to the occluded region. Thanks to these strategies, we can learn to reconstruct the complete object even in a clustered scene. Please refer to the paper for more details. Now, please enjoy some example of editable scene rendering. Here are the links to our project. You can scan the left QR code to visit our project page. Thank you for listening.